This channel has been established for visually impaired people. For the visually impaired people, voice narration and a written expression are also provided for the hearing impaired. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Arabic Arabic, Al Arabiya. And is used to varying degrees in workplaces, government, and the media. The two formal varieties are grouped together as literary Arabic, which is the official language of 26 states, and the liturgical language of Islam. Modern Standard Arabic largely follows the grammatical standards of Quranic Arabic and uses much of the same vocabulary. However, it has discarded some grammatical constructions and vocabulary that no longer have any counterpart in the spoken varieties, and has adopted certain new constructions and vocabulary from the spoken varieties. Much of the new vocabulary is used to denote concepts that have arisen in the post-Quranic era, especially in modern times. Arabic is written with the Arabic alphabet, which is an abjad script and is written from right to left, although the spoken varieties are sometimes written in ASCII Latin from left to right with no standardized forms. Arabic has influenced many languages around the globe throughout its history. Some of the most influenced languages are Persian, Turkish, Urdu, Kurdish, Bosnian, Kazakh, Bengali, Hindi, Malay, Maldivian, Indonesian, Pashto, Punjabi, Tagalog, Sindhi, and Hausa, and some languages in parts of Africa during the Middle Ages. Literary Arabic was a major vehicle of culture in Europe, especially in science, mathematics, and philosophy. As a result, many European languages have also borrowed many words from it. Many words of Arabic origin are also found in ancient languages like Latin and Greek. Arabic influence, mainly in vocabulary, is seen in European languages, mainly Spanish and Portuguese, owing to both the proximity of Christian European and Muslim Arab civilizations and 800 years of Arabic culture and language in the Iberian Peninsula. Referred to in Arabic as Al-Andalus, Balkan languages, including Greek, have also acquired a significant number of Arabic vocabulary through contact with Ottoman Turkish. Arabic has also borrowed words from many languages, including Hebrew, Aramaic, Greek, Persian, and Syriac in early centuries, Kurdish in medieval times, and contemporary European languages in modern times, mostly English and French. Contents 1. Classification 2. History 21. Arabic History 22. Middle Arabic, Neo-Arabic, and Classical Arabic 23. Modern Arabic 3. Classical, Modern Standard, and Spoken Arabic 4. Language and Dialect 5. Influence of Arabic on other languages 6. Influence of other languages on Arabic 7. Arabic alphabet and nationalism 71. Lebanon 72. Egypt 8. Arabic and Islam 9. Dialects and descendants 91. Examples 92. Coin 93. Dialect groups 10. Phonology 101. History 102. Literary Arabic 10. 21. Vowels 10. 22. Consonants 10. 23. Syllable structure 10. 24. Stress 10. 25. Levels of pronunciation 10,251. Full pronunciation 10,252. Full pronunciation with pausa 10,253. Formal short pronunciation 10,254. Informal short pronunciation 103. Colloquial varieties 10.31. Vowels 10.32. Consonants 11. Grammar 111. Literary Arabic 11.11. Nouns and adjectives 11.12. Verbs 11.13. Derivation 112. Colloquial varieties 12. Writing system 121. Calligraphy 122. Romanization 123. Numerals 13. Language standards regulators 14. As a foreign language 15. Arabic speakers and other languages languages 16. See also 17. References 18. External links. Classification. Arabic is a Central Semitic language, closely related to the Northwest Semitic languages Aramaic, Hebrew, Ugaritic and Phoenician, the ancient South Arabian languages, and various other Semitic languages of Arabia such as Dadanitic. The Semitic languages changed a great deal between Proto-Semitic and the establishment of the Central Semitic languages, particularly in terms of grammar. Innovations of the Central Semitic languages, all maintained in Arabic, include, the conversion of the suffix conjugated state of formation katala into a past tense, the conversion of the prefix conjugated preterite tense formation yaktal into a present tense, the elimination of other prefix conjugated mood, aspect forms e.g., a present tense formed by doubling the middle root, a perfect formed by infixing a, t, after the first root consonant, probably a jussive formed by a stress shift in favor of new moods formed by endings attached to the prefix conjugation forms e.g., u for indicative, a for subjunctive, no ending for jussive, and or ana for energetic. The development of an internal passive. There are several features which Classical Arabic, the modern Arabic varieties, as well as the Safedic and Hismaic inscriptions share which are unattested in any other Central Semitic language variety, including the Dadanitic and Taimanitic languages of the northern Hejaz. These features are evidence of common descent from a hypothetical ancestor. Proto-Arabic. The following features can be reconstructed with confidence for Proto-Arabic: negative particles m ma, l enlaan. Main article, Old Arabic Arabia boasted a wide variety of Semitic languages in antiquity in the southwest. Various Central Semitic languages both belonging to and outside of the ancient South Arabian family, e.g. Southern Thamudic, were spoken. It is also believed that the ancestors of the modern South Arabian languages, non-Central Semitic languages, were also spoken in Southern Arabia at this time. To the north, in the oases of Northern Hejaz, Dadanitic and Taimanitic held some prestige as inscriptional languages in Najd and parts of Western Arabia. A language known to scholars as Thamudic C is attested in Eastern Arabia. Inscriptions in a script derived from Asa attest to a language known as Hassaitic. Finally, on the northwestern frontier of Arabia, various languages known to scholars as Thamudic B, Thamudic D, Safedic, and Hismaic are attested. The last two share important isoglosses with later forms of Arabic, leading scholars to theorize that Safedic and Hismaic are in fact early forms of Arabic and that they should be considered Old Arabic. Aramaic also held prestige as a written language in parts of northern and eastern Arabia in antiquity in the northwestern frontier. The Nabataean dialect of Aramaic and its associated script had become familiar to the ancestors of the Arabs in the earliest Nabataean inscriptions. Arabic names and idioms are attested starting from the 1st century CE. Fragments of Old Arabic prose are attested in the Nabataean script across northern and central Arabia. Throughout late antiquity, the use of the ancient North Arabian scripts and their associated languages declines in Arabia, and an Old Arabic written standard in a transitional Nabateo-Arabic script emerges. Middle Arabic, Neo-Arabic, and Classical Arabic in late pre-Islamic times, a transdialectal and transcommunal variety of Arabic emerged, already standardized in actual fact, which continued living its parallel life after literary Arabic had been institutionally standardized in the 2nd and 3rd century of the Hijra, keeping alive ancient features eliminated from the learned tradition. Classical Arabic. This variety and both its classicizing and lay iterations are termed Middle Arabic. The so-called Rajah's poetry of pre-Islamic is a good example of the use of a sophisticated variety of Middle Arabic. The same can be said, some centuries later, about the Andalusian Zajjal. Middle Arabic was structurally connected to the so-called Neo-Arabic dialects, a catch-all term for the modern varieties of Arabic and their immediate ancestors. Charles Ferguson's coin theory. Ferguson, 1959, claims that the modern Arabic dialects collectively descend from a single military coin that sprung up during the Islamic conquests. This view has been challenged in recent times. Ahmad al-Jalad proposes that there were at least two considerably distinct types of Arabic on the eve of the conquests, Northern and Central. Al-Jalad, 2009. The modern dialects emerged from a new contact situation produced following the conquests instead of the emergence of a single or multiple coins. The dialects contained several sedimentary layers of borrowed and aerial features, which they absorbed at different points in their linguistic histories. In the late 6th century AD, a relatively uniform intertribal poetic coin distinct from the spoken vernaculars developed based on the Bedouin dialects of Najd, probably in connection with the court of Al-Hira. During the first Islamic century, the majority of Arabic poets and Arabic writing persons spoke Arabic as their mother tongue. Their texts, although mainly preserved in far later manuscripts, contain traces of non-standardized classical Arabic elements in morphology and syntax. Furthermore, it is clear that the orthography of the Qur'an was not developed for the standardized form of classical Arabic. Rather, it shows the attempt on the part of writers to utilize a traditional writing system for recording a non-standardized form of classical Arabic. The standardization of classical Arabic reached completion around the end of the 8th century. The first comprehensive description of the Arabiya, Arabic, Sabawayhi's Al-Kitab, is based first of all upon a corpus of poetic texts, in addition to the Qur'an and Bedouin informants whom he considered to be reliable speakers of the Arabiya. By the 8th century, knowledge of classical Arabic had become an essential prerequisite for rising into the higher classes throughout the Islamic world. Modern Arabic During the colonial era, the European powers occupying Arab nations actively encouraged the public spread and use of colloquial Arabic dialects and suppressed the use and teaching of classical Arabic. This caused great diversity in dialects throughout the Near East, Northern Africa, and even Eastern European dialects of Arabic like Czech Arabic and Slavo-Andersky Arabic. After wiping out a third of the Algerian population between 1830 and 1872, for example, the French then closed all Quranic schools and banned public usage of Arabic. Arabic was actually declared a foreign language in 1938, and while about half the population was literate in Arabic at the beginning of French colonization, 90% of the native population was illiterate in both Arabic and French by its end in the 1960s. Classical, Modern Standard and Spoken Arabic. See also, List of Arabic dictionaries. Arabic usually designates one of three main variants: Classical Arabic, Modern Standard Arabic, and Colloquial or Dialectal Arabic. Classical Arabic is the language found in the Quran, used from the period of pre-Islamic Arabia to that of the Abbasid Caliphate. Theoretically, Classical Arabic is considered normative, according to the syntactic and grammatical norms laid down by classical grammarians such as Sabawi and the vocabulary defined in classical dictionaries such as the Lisan al-Arab. In practice, however, modern authors almost never write in pure Classical Arabic, instead using a literary language with its own grammatical norms and vocabulary. Commonly known as Modern Standard Arabic, MSA. MSA is the variety used in most current, printed Arabic publications, spoken by some of the Arabic media across North Africa, the Horn of Africa and the Middle East, and understood by most educated Arabic speakers. Literary Arabic and Standard Arabic Fush are less strictly defined terms that may refer to Modern Standard Arabic or Classical Arabic. Some of the differences between Classical Arabic CA and Modern Standard Arabic MSA are as follows: certain grammatical constructions of CA that have no counterpart in any modern dialect, e.g., the energetic mood are almost never used in modern standard Arabic. No modern spoken variety of Arabic has case distinctions as a result. MSA is generally composed without case distinctions in mind, and the proper cases are added after the fact, when necessary, because most case endings are noted using final short vowels, which are normally left unwritten in the Arabic script. It is unnecessary to determine the proper case of most words. The practical result of this is that MSA, like English and Standard Chinese, is written in a strongly determined word order, and alternative orders that were used in CA for emphasis are rare. In addition, because of the lack of case marking in the spoken varieties, most speakers cannot consistently use the correct endings in extemporaneous speech. As a result, spoken MSA tends to drop or regularize the endings except when reading from a prepared text. The numeral system in CA is complex and heavily tied in with the case system. This system is never used in MSA, even in the most formal of circumstances. Instead, a significantly simplified system is used, approximating the system of the conservative spoken varieties. MSA uses much classical vocabulary, e.g., dahaba to go, that is not present in the spoken varieties. In addition, MSA has borrowed or coined a large number of terms for concepts that did not exist in Quranic times, and MSA continues to evolve. Some words have been borrowed from other languages. Notice that transliteration mainly indicates spelling and not real pronunciation, e.g., film, film, or democratia, democracy. However, the current preference is to avoid direct borrowings, preferring to either use loan translations, e.g., far, branch, also used for the branch of a company or organization, jinnah, wing, is also used for the wing of an airplane, building, air force, etc., or to coin new words using forms within existing roots. Istimata, apoptosis, using the root m, with t, death, put into the tenth form, or jami'a, university, based on jama, to gather, unite, jumhuriya, republic, based on jumhur, multitude. An earlier tendency was to redefine older word, although this has fallen into disuse, e.g., hatif, telephone. Caller in Sufism, yurida, newspaper. The Eastern phonology. It is this phonology that underlies the modern pronunciation of Classical Arabic. The phonological differences between these two dialects account for some of the complexities of Arabic writing, most notably the writing of the glottal stop or hamza, which was preserved in the Eastern dialects but lost in Western speech, and the use of alif maksura, representing a sound preserved in the Western dialects but merged with a in Eastern speech language and dialect. The sociolinguistic situation of Arabic in modern times provides a prime example example of the linguistic phenomenon of diglossia, which is the normal use of two separate varieties of the same language, usually in different social situations. In the case of Arabic, educated Arabs of any nationality can be assumed to speak both their school-taught standard Arabic as well as their native, mutually unintelligible dialects. These dialects linguistically constitute separate languages which may have dialects of their own. When educated Arabs of different dialects engage in conversation, for example, a Moroccan speaking with a Lebanese, many speakers code switch back and forth between the dialectal and standard varieties of the language. Sometimes even within the same sentence, Arabic speakers often improve their familiarity with other dialects via music or film. The issue of whether Arabic is one language or many languages is politically charged, in the same way it is for the varieties of Chinese, Hindi and Urdu, Serbian and Croatian, Scots and English, etc. In contrast to speakers of Hindi and Urdu who claim they cannot understand each other even when they can, speakers of the varieties of Arabic will claim they can all understand each other even when they cannot. The issue of diglossia between spoken and written language is a significant complicating factor. A single written form, significantly different from any of the spoken varieties learned natively, unites a number of sometimes divergent spoken forms for political reasons. Arabs mostly assert that they all speak a single language, despite significant issues of mutual incomprehensibility among differing spoken versions from a linguistic standpoint. It is often said that the various spoken varieties of Arabic differ among each other collectively about as much as the Romance languages. This is an apt comparison in a number of ways. The period of divergence from a single spoken form is similar, perhaps 1,500 years for Arabic, 2,000 years for the Romance languages. Also, while it is comprehensible to people from the Maghreb, a linguistically innovative variety such as Moroccan Arabic is essentially incomprehensible to Arabs from the Mashriq, much as French is incomprehensible to Spanish or Italian speakers but relatively easily learned by them. This suggests that the spoken varieties may linguistically be considered separate languages. Influence of Arabic on other languages. See also, list of Arabic loanwords in English. The influence of Arabic has been most important in Islamic countries, because it is the language of the Islamic sacred book, the Quran. Arabic is also an important source of vocabulary for languages such as Baluchi, Bengali, Berber, Bosnian, Catalan, Chechen, Dagestani, English, French, German, Gujarati, Hausa, Hindustani, Italian, Indonesian, Kazakh, Kurdish, Kuchi, Malay, Malayalam, Pashto, Persian, Portuguese, Punjabi, Rohingya, Saraiki, Sicilian, Sindhi, Somali, Spanish, Swahili, Tagalog, Turkish, Urdu, Uzbek, and Wolof, as well as other languages in countries where these languages are spoken. In addition, English has many Arabic loanwords, some directly, but most via other Mediterranean languages. Examples of such words include admiral, adobe, alchemy, alcohol, algebra, algorithm, alkaline, almanac, amber, arsenal, assassin, candy, carrot, cipher, coffee, coffee, cotton, ghoul, hazard, jar, kismet, lemon, loofah, magazine, mattress, sherbet, sofa, sumac, tariff, and many other words. Other languages such as Maltese and Kinubi derive ultimately from Arabic, rather than merely borrowing vocabulary or grammatical rules. Terms borrowed range from religious terminology like Berber tazelat, prayer, from salat salah, academic terms like Uyghur mentic, logic, and economic items like English coffee to placeholders like Spanish fulano, so and so. Everyday terms like Hindustani lekin, but, or Spanish taza and French tas, meaning cup, and expressions like Catalan abetza. Galore, in quantity, most Berber varieties such as Kabyle, along with Swahili, borrow some numbers from Arabic. Most Islamic religious terms are direct borrowings from Arabic, such as salat, prayer, and imam, prayer leader. In languages not directly in contact with the Arab world, Arabic loanwords are often transferred indirectly via other languages rather than being transferred directly from Arabic. For example, most Arabic loanwords in Hindustani entered through Persian, though Persian is an Indo-Iranian language. Older Arabic loanwords in Hausa were borrowed from Kanuri. Some words in English and other European languages are derived from Arabic, often through other European languages, especially Spanish and Italian. Among them are commonly used words like coffee, kawa, cotton, Cuton, and magazine Macazin. English words more recognizably of Arabic origin include algebra, alcohol, alchemy, alkali, zenith, and nadir. Arabic words also made their way into several West African languages as Islam spread across the Sahara. Variants of Arabic words such as kitab book have spread to the languages of African groups who had no direct contact with Arab traders since throughout the Islamic world. Arabic occupied a position similar to that of Latin in Europe. Many of the Arabic concepts in the fields of science, philosophy, commerce, etc. were coined from Arabic roots by non-native Arabic speakers, notably by Aramaic and Persian translators, and then found their way into other languages. This process of using Arabic roots, especially in Kurdish and Persian, to translate foreign concepts continued through to the 18th and 19th centuries, when swaths of Arab inhabited lands were under Ottoman rule. Influence of other languages on Arabic. The most important sources of borrowings into pre-Islamic Arabic are from the related Semitic languages Aramaic, which used to be the principal, international language of communication throughout the ancient Near and Middle East, Ethiopic, and to a lesser degree Hebrew, mainly religious concepts. In addition, many cultural, religious and political terms have entered Arabic from Iranian languages, notably Middle Persian, Parthian, and Classical Persian, and Hellenistic Greek. Kimi has as origin the Greek chimia, meaning in that language the melting of metals. See Roger de Chez, Histoire de la Médecine de l'Antiquité au XXe siècle, Talendier, 2008, p. and has its origin in the Syriac Gezira. Lazaward is taken from Persian lajvard, the name of a blue stone, lapis lazuli. This word was borrowed in several European languages to mean light blue, azure in English, azur in French and azul in Spanish. Arabic alphabet and nationalism. There have been many instances of national movements to convert Arabic script into Latin script or to Romanize the language. Lebanon. The Beirut newspaper La Siri pushed for the change from Arabic script to Latin script in 1922. The major head of this movement was Louis Massignon, a French Orientalist, who brought his concern before the Arabic Language Academy in Damascus in 1928. Massignon's attempt at Romanization failed as the academy and population viewed the proposal as an attempt from the Western world to take over their country. Saeed Afghani, a member of the academy, mentioned that the movement to Romanize the script was a Zionist plan to dominate Lebanon. Egypt. After the period of colonialism in Egypt, Egyptians were looking for a way to reclaim and re-emphasize Egyptian culture. As a result, some Egyptians pushed for an Egyptianization of the Arabic language, in which the formal Arabic and the colloquial Arabic would be combined into one language and the Latin alphabet would be used. There was also the idea of finding a way to use hieroglyphics instead of the Latin alphabet, but this was seen as too complicated to use. A scholar, Salama Musa, agreed with the idea of applying a Latin alphabet to Arabic, as he believed that would allow Egypt to have a closer relationship with the West. He also believed that Latin script was key to the success of Egypt, as it would allow for more advances in science and technology. This change in script, he believed, would solve the problems inherent with Arabic, such as a lack of written vowels and difficulties writing foreign words that made it difficult for non-native speakers to learn. Ahmad Lutfi as Saeed and Muhammad Azmi, two Egyptian intellectuals, agreed with Musa and supported the push for Romanization. The idea that Romanization was necessary for modernization and growth in Egypt continued with Abd al-Aziz Fahmy in 1944. He was the chairman for the Writing and Grammar Committee for the Arabic Language Academy of Cairo. However, this effort failed as the Egyptian people felt a strong cultural tie to the Arabic alphabet in particular. The older Egyptian generations believed that the Arabic alphabet had strong connections to Arab values and history, which is easy to believe due to the long history of the Arabic alphabet. Shriftil, 189. Arabic and Islam. Classical Arabic is the language of poetry and literature, including news. It's also mainly the language of the Quran. Arabic is closely associated with the religion of Islam because the Quran was written in Arabic, but it is nevertheless also spoken by Arab Christians, Mizrahi Jews and Iraqi Mandaeans. Most of the world's Muslims do not speak classical Arabic as their native language, but many can read the Quranic script and recite the Quran among non-Arab Muslims. Translations of the Quran are most often accompanied by the original text. Some Muslims present a monogenesis of languages and claim that the Arabic language was the language revealed revealed by God for the benefit of mankind, and the original language is a prototype system of symbolic communication, based upon its system of triconsonantal roots, spoken by man from which all other languages were derived. Having first been corrupted, Judaism has a similar account with the Tower of Babel dialects and descendants. Different dialects of Arabic. Main article, varieties of Arabic. Colloquial Arabic is a collective term for the spoken dialects of Arabic used throughout the Arab world, which differ radically from the literary language. The main dialectal division is between the varieties within and outside of the Arabian Peninsula, followed by that between sedentary varieties and the much more conservative Bedouin varieties. All of the varieties outside of the Arabian Peninsula, which include the large majority of speakers, have a large number of features in common with each other that are not found in classical Arabic. This has led researchers to postulate the existence of a prestige coin dialect in the one or two centuries immediately following the Arab conquest, whose features eventually spread to all of the newly conquered areas. These features are present to varying degrees inside the Arabian Peninsula generally. The Arabian Peninsula varieties have much more diversity than the non-peninsula varieties, but have been understudied within the non-peninsula varieties. The largest difference is between the non-Egyptian North African dialects, especially Moroccan Arabic and the others. Moroccan Arabic in particular is hardly comprehensible to Arabic speakers east of Libya, although the converse is not true, in part due to the popularity of Egyptian films and other media. One factor in the differentiation of the dialects is influence from the languages previously spoken in the areas, which have typically provided a significant number of new words and have sometimes also influenced pronunciation or word order. However, a much more significant factor for most dialects is, as among Romance languages, retention or change of meaning of different classical forms. Thus Iraqi Aku, Levantine Fi and North African Kane all mean there is, and all come from classical Arabic forms Yakin, Fihi, Kain respectively, but now sound very different. Examples. Transcription is a broad IPA transcription, so minor differences were ignored for easier comparison. Anna Inhib Algraya Wajid variety. I love reading a lot. When I went to the library, I didn't find this old book. One wanted to read a book about the history of women in France. Literary Arabic in Arabic script dialects are written in other non-standardized spellings. Classical Arabic liturgical or poetic only. Uhib ul Kira Atta Ka Theta I Ara. Indama Ahabtu Ila El Maktaba Lam Idu Ha A El Kita Ba El Qadim Kuntu Yuri Du An Akar A Kita Ban An Tarishi El Mar Ati Fi Far Ansa. Modern Standard Arabic Ub Al Kra A Ka Theta Iran. Nadama Ahabtu La El Maktaba Lam Ad D Ha A El Kata B Al Qadim Kuntu Yuri Du An Akra Kata B An Tari X Al Mara Fi Faransa. Yemeni Arabic Sana Anna Bajan Ahib El Ge Raja Gawi La Ma Sert Sala, El Maktab Mala Ge, T, Aji Al Kata B El Gadi M Kant Ati Agra Kata B An Tari X Al Mare Wast Fa Ra Nsa Gulf Arabic Kuwait A Na Wa Yid Ab Ara Laman Art Il Maktab Mali T Hal Kata B El Gadi M Kint Abi Ara Kita B An Tari X Il Hari Mib Faransa Gilat Mesopotamian Baghdad Ania Hib El Q Ra Ya Kuli Laman Rehit Lel Maktaba Mali E T Ha A El Kita B Al Qadim Readit A Qra Kita B An Tari X Al Niswan Eb Fransa Hijazi Arabic Medina Anna Mara A Hub Al Ira Ya Lama Rut Al Maktaba Mali E T Ha Da El Kita B Al Adi M Kunt Aba Ara Kita B An Tari X Al Hari M Fi Faransa. Western Syrian Arabic Damascus Anna Ktir Bib El Raja Lama Art Al Maktab Ma Lay T Ha El K Ta B L D M Ka N Badi Ra Kta B An Ta Re X El Mara B Fra Nsa. Lebanese Arabic Beirut Ktir Bhbb El Rija Lama Rate Al Maktab Ma Li T Ha L K Ta B La D M K N Badi Ra K T E B An Ta Re X L Mara Bi Fra N S A. Urban Palestinian Jerusalem Anna Baheb El Raji K T I R Lama Ru T Al Maktab Ma La E T Ha L K Ta B L A D M Ka N Bedi R K T A B An Ta Re X L Mur Fi F Ransa. Rural Palestinian West Bank Anna Baheb El Kuraji K Theta I R Lama Ru T Al Matabi Ma La K T Ha L T Ta B L K D M Ka N Bedi Kur T D A B An Ta Re X L Mur Fi F Ransa. Egyptian Metropolitan Anna Bayeb El Ur J W Lem Ash wrote El Make Tebe Ma El Et L K T Ash B L Ash D M De Ini Kant E A U S Ara K T Ash B A N T Ash Re X L Set Ta T Fe. F. Ash Rainzi Libyan Arabic Tripoli Anna NHB Il Ra Ya Halba Lama Mi T Lil Maktba Mail T Ha Li Kta Bld M Kunt Nibi Nara Kta B Li Tari X, Nsawin Fi Fra Nsa Tunisian Tunis NHB Likur J Bray Wektali Mi T Miktba Mail Chi T Hay Lakt B Elkti M Kunt NHB Nakri Kt B Le Trix Lmra Fi Fr Nsa Algerian Algiers E Na Neb Lqra Ya Bezif Ki Rut L Il Maktaba Ma Lqit, Ha Lkte B Lqdim Kunt Ha B Nakra Kte B Ala Tari X Lmra Fi Fra Nsa Moroccan Rabat Anna Ziz Lia Bzzafnqra. Meli Mit L Elmaktaba Ma Lqit, Had Lkta B Lqdim Kent by Nqra Kta B La Tarix Lmra F França Maltese Valletta NHP NRHFN MT Mert L Laburge M SBT DN L Ktip DM Ard NR Ktiep Dur L Street TL Mer F France Maltese Valletta in Maltese Orthography Inhab Nakra Hafna Meta Mort Il Liberia Ma SIBTX Dan Il Khatib Khatam RIDT Nakra Khatib D WARL Istorja Tal Mara Phi Franza coin. According to Charles A. Ferguson, the following are some of the characteristic features of the coin that underlies all of the modern dialects outside the Arabian Peninsula, although many other features are common to most or all of these varieties. Ferguson believes that these features in particular are unlikely to have evolved independently more than once or twice and together suggest the existence of the coin, loss of the dual grammatical number except on nouns, with consistent plural agreement cf. feminine singular agreement in plural inanimates change of a to I in many affixes e.g., non-past tense prefixes to yi ni, y, and il, the feminine it in the construct state loss of third weak verbs ending in w which merge with verbs ending in y reformation of geminate verbs, e.g., halal to I untied, haledu conversion of separate words li to me, laka to you, etc. into indirect object clitic suffixes. Certain changes in the cardinal number system, e.g., kamsat am, 5 days, commas tiam, where certain words have a special plural with prefix t. Loss of the feminine elative comparative adjective plurals of the form kabar, big, kubar. Change of nisba suffix iyy. Dialect groups. Egyptian Arabic is spoken by around 53 million in Egypt, 55 million worldwide. It is one of the most understood varieties of Arabic, due in large part to the widespread distribution of Egyptian films and television shows throughout the Arabic-speaking world. Levantine Arabic includes North Levantine Arabic, South Levantine Arabic, and Cypriot Arabic. It is spoken by about 21 million people in Lebanon, Syria, Jordan, Palestine, Israel, Cyprus, and Turkey. Maghrebi Arabic, also called Daria, spoken by about 70 million people in Morocco, Algeria, Tunisia, Libya, and Malta. It is very hard to understand for Arabic speakers from the Mashriq or Mesopotamia, the easiest being Libyan Arabic and the hardest Moroccan Arabic and Maltese language, which is close to Tunisian Arabic. The others, such as Algerian Arabic, can be considered in between. Maltese, spoken on the island of Malta, is the only dialect to have established itself as a fully separate language, with independent literary norms. Sicilian Arabic, spoken on the island of Sicily until the 14th century, developed into Maltese in Malta in the course of its history. The language has adopted numerous loanwords, phonetic and phonological features, and even some grammatical patterns, from Italian, Sicilian, and English. It is also the only Semitic language written in the Latin script. Furthermore, Maltese or Sicilian Arabic are closely related to Tunisian Arabic due to the cultural and historical ties between Tunisia and Malta, and the languages are partially mutually intelligible. Mesopotamian Arabic, spoken by about 7 million people in Iraq, where it is called Amaya, eastern Syria and southwestern Iran. Khuzestan Khuzestani Arabic, spoken in the Iranian province of Khuzestan. Khorasani Arabic, spoken in the Iranian province of Khorasan. Sudanese Arabic is spoken by 17 million people in Sudan and some parts of southern Egypt. Sudanese Arabic is quite distinct from the dialect of its neighbor to the north. Rather, the Sudanese have a dialect similar to the Hijazi dialect. Juba Arabic, spoken in South Sudan and Southern Sudan. Gulf Arabic, spoken by around 4 million people, predominantly in Kuwait, Bahrain, some parts of Oman, eastern Saudi Arabia, coastal areas, and some parts of UAE and Qatar. Also spoken in Iran's Busha and Hormozgan provinces. Although Gulf Arabic is spoken in Qatar, most Qatari citizens speak Najdi Arabic. Badawi Yemeni Arabic spoken in Yemen, Somalia, Djibouti and southern Saudi Arabia by 15 million people, similar to Gulf Arabic Najdi Arabic, spoken by around 10 million people, mainly spoken in Najd, central and northern Saudi Arabia. Most Qatari citizens speak Najdi Arabic Badawi. Hijazi Arabic 6 million speakers, spoken in Hejaz, western Saudi Arabia. Hassaniya Arabic 3 million speakers, spoken in Mauritania, western Sahara, some parts of northern Mali, southern Morocco and southwestern Algeria. Saharan Arabic spoken in some parts of Algeria, Niger and Mali. Bahraini Arabic 600,000 speakers, spoken by Bahraini Shia in Bahrain and Qatif. The dialect exhibits many big differences from Gulf Arabic. It is also spoken to a lesser extent in Oman. Judeo-Arabic dialects. These are the dialects spoken by the Jews that had lived or continue to live in the Arab world as Jewish migration to Israel took hold. The language did not thrive and is now considered endangered. Cypriot Maronite Arabic, spoken in Cyprus. Chadian Arabic, spoken in Chad, Sudan, some parts of South Sudan, Central African Republic, Niger, Nigeria, Cameroon. Central Asian Arabic, spoken in Uzbekistan, Tajikistan and Afghanistan, is highly endangered. Samaritan Arabic, spoken by only several hundred in the Nablus region. Shirvani Arabic, spoken in Azerbaijan and Dagestan until the 1930s, now extinct. Siculo Arabic, was spoken in Sicily and Malta between the end of the 9th century and the end of the 12th century. Andalusian Arabic, spoken in Spain and Portugal until the 16th century. Phonology. Main article, Arabic phonology. History. Bilingual traffic sign in Qatar. Of the 29 Proto-Semitic consonants, only one has been lost, which merged with, but the consonant is still found in many colloquial Arabic dialects. Various other consonants have changed their sound too, but have remained distinct and original. P, lenited to F, and consistently attested in pre-Islamic Greek transcription of Arabic languages, became palatalized to, or, by the time of the Quran and D, or, in MSAC Arabic phonology. Hashtag local variations. For more detail, an original voiceless alveolar lateral fricative became its emphatic counterpart, tilde, was considered by Arabs to be the most unusual sound in Arabic, hence the classical Arabic's appellation lughat al-dad or language of the dad. For most modern dialects, it has become an emphatic stop, d, with loss of the laterality or with complete loss of any pharyngealization or velarization. D, the classical dad pronunciation of pharyngealization, still occurs in the Mari language. And the similar sound without velarization exists in other modern South Arabian languages. Other changes may also have happened. Classical Arabic pronunciation is not thoroughly recorded, and different reconstructions of the sound system of Proto-Semitic propose different phonetic values. One example is the emphatic consonants, which are pharyngealized in modern pronunciations but may have been velarized in the 8th century and glottalized in Proto-Semitic. Reduction of j and with between vowels occurs in a number of circumstances and is responsible for much of the complexity of third weak defective verbs. Early Akkadian transcriptions of Arabic names shows that this reduction had not yet occurred as of the early part of the first millennium BC. The classical Arabic language as recorded was a poetic coin that reflected a consciously archaizing dialect, chosen based on the tribes of the western part of the Arabian Peninsula, who spoke the most conservative variants of Arabic even at the time of Muhammad and before. Other dialects existed with many more changes, including the loss of most glottal stops, the loss of case endings, the reduction of the diphthongs, aj, and a, into monophthongs, e, o, etc. Most of these changes are present in most or all modern varieties of Arabic. An interesting feature of the writing system of the Quran and hence of classical Arabic is that it contains certain features of Muhammad's native dialect of Mecca, corrected through diacritics into the forms of standard classical Arabic. Among these features visible under the corrections are the loss of the glottal stop and a differing development of the reduction of certain final sequences containing j. Evidently, final awa became a, as in the classical language, but final asia became a different sound, possibly e, rather than again a. In the classical language, this is the apparent source of the aleph maxura, restricted aleph, where a final asia is reconstructed, a letter that would normally indicate J, or some similar high vowel sound, but is taken in this context to be a logical variant of Aleph and represent the sound A. Literary Arabic. The colloquial spoken varieties of Arabic are learned at home and constitute the native languages of Arabic speakers. Formal literary Arabic, usually specifically modern standard Arabic, is learned at school. Although many speakers have a native-like command of the language, it is technically not the native language of any speakers. Both varieties can be both both written and spoken, although the colloquial varieties are rarely written down and the formal variety is spoken mostly in formal circumstances, e.g., in radio broadcasts, formal lectures, parliamentary discussions and to some extent between speakers of different colloquial varieties even when the literary language is spoken, however, it is normally only spoken in its pure form when reading. A prepared text out loud when speaking extemporaneously, i.e. making up the language on the spot, as in a normal discussion among people, speakers tend to deviate somewhat from the strict literary language in the direction of the colloquial varieties. In fact, there is a continuous range of in-between spoken varieties, from nearly pure modern standard Arabic MSA, to a form that still uses MSA grammar and vocabulary but with significant colloquial influence, to a form of the colloquial language that imports a number of words and grammatical constructions in MSA, to a form that is close to pure colloquial but with the rough edges, the most noticeably vulgar or non-classical aspects smoothed out, to pure colloquial. The particular variant or register used depends on the social class and education level of the speakers involved and the level of formality of the speech situation. Often it will vary within a single encounter, e.g., moving from nearly pure MSA to a more mixed language in the process of a radio interview. As the interviewee becomes more comfortable with the interviewer, this type of variation is characteristic of the diglossia that exists throughout the Arabic-speaking world. Recording of a poem by Al-Ma'ri titled, I No Longer Steal From Nature. Although modern standard Arabic MSA is a unitary language, its pronunciation varies somewhat from country to country and from region to region. Within a country, the variation in individual accents of MSA speakers tends to mirror corresponding variations in the colloquial speech of the speakers in question, but with the distinguishing characteristics moderated somewhat. Note that it is important in descriptions of Arabic phonology to distinguish between pronunciation of a given colloquial spoken dialect and the pronunciation of MSA by these same speakers. Although they are related, they are not the same. For example, the phoneme that derives from Proto-Semitic per gram has many different pronunciations in the modern spoken varieties, e.g., d, tilde, tilde, j, tilde, tilde. Speakers whose native variety has either or will use the same pronunciation when speaking MSA. Even speakers from Cairo, whose native Egyptian Arabic has, normally use when speaking MSA. The of Persian Gulf speakers is the only variant pronunciation which isn't found in MSA, is used instead. Another example, many colloquial varieties are known for a type of vowel harmony in which the presence of an emphatic consonant triggers backed allophones of nearby vowels, especially of the low vowels, a, which are backed to in these circumstances and very often fronted to in all other circumstances. In many spoken varieties, the backed or emphatic vowel allophones spread a fair distance in both directions from the triggering consonant. In some varieties, most notably Egyptian Arabic, the emphatic allophones spread throughout the entire word, usually including prefixes and suffixes, even at a distance of several syllables from the triggering consonant. Speakers of colloquial varieties with this vowel harmony tend to introduce it into their MSA pronunciation as well, but usually with a lesser degree of spreading than in the colloquial varieties. For example, speakers of colloquial varieties with extremely long-distance harmony may allow a moderate, but not extreme, amount of spreading of the harmonic allophones in their MSA speech, while speakers of colloquial varieties with moderate-distance harmony may only harmonize immediately adjacent vowels in MSA vowels. Modern standard Arabic has six pure vowels, with short, a, u, and corresponding long vowels, a, I, u. There are also two diphthongs, a, j, and a. The pronunciation of the vowels differs from speaker to speaker, in a way that tends to reflect the pronunciation of the corresponding colloquial variety. Nonetheless, there are some common trends. Most noticeable is the differing pronunciation of a and a, which tend towards fronted, or in most situations, but a back in the neighborhood of emphatic consonants. Some accents and dialects, such as those of the Hejaz, have central in all situations. The vowels u and are often affected somewhat in emphatic neighborhoods as well, with generally more back or centralized allophones, but the differences are less great than for the low vowels. The pronunciation of short u and I tends towards an in many dialects. The definition of both emphatic and neighborhood vary in ways that reflect to some extent corresponding variations in the spoken dialects. Generally, the consonants triggering emphatic allophones are the pharyngealized consonants t, ds, ed, q, and r. If